Hey guys, Akash here. Today I will be showing you the complete guide like how to set up your Skyline Edge emulator from installation to running a game. First thing, this Edge version is from a friend only for a review purpose and this is not a promotion video. So let's start with the video. So in Edge 72, what is new? So there is a minor bug fixes where initially it used to crash while trying to open the Skyline for the first time, which was introduced in H71 and mainline 2498. Here I am going to install the H72. So as the installation is completed, the first thing that you will get is to select the folder. So select the path where you have all the ROMs placed. So we will be selecting this folder that I have created separately for Skyline. So here we will get this kind of icons here with a question mark. So this is because the product key and the title key is missing for now. So where you can get the product and the title key? The best thing that you can do is to get it extracted from your own Nintendo Switch. If you don't have a Nintendo Switch and you are looking for an easy way, you can get it from other emulators which is already available on PC. So there are two ways to select the product key and the title key. You can go directly from here and select the place where you have saved the product key and the title key one by one, or you can create a separate folder for your keys which can include a product key and the title key and can go ahead and paste it in the same folder which is actually selected for your ROMs. So after you have saved and selected the product key, just refresh the page. So now it will reflect like this. After refreshing the page, there are still bugs with this Skyline. So you will have to wait for a stable version in the coming future. So starting with Pokémon Legend Arceus. So for this game, there is one thing that you need to do is so just go ahead and change the system driver. So select the 676.12. It works on this one fine. So let's try again. It boots up. So moving on to the next game for Pokemon Violet. It works on the custom driver and also the default driver that you get on the directly from the phone. Moving on to the third game, Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. You will have to do some changes. It runs on the both the drivers, but for running this game you will have to disable this dock mode and this will let you in. So this is how it works. So moving on to the last step, where how you can run the save file from on this emulator. So first thing that you will be needing is the save files. So I have all the game save file here. So just select here, copy it. I have to actually go on under Android data, select the Skyline files, switch, and user save. And here, so this is the place where you have to save all your save files. Just paste here, it's all good. Now let's move on to the game. So let's just check for one of the game if the save file is working or not. So before testing the save files, the settings that you have to do is, so after turning this performance statics, it will show you the FPS for the game that you're running on. You can change the RAM from here. The more the RAM, the better the performance will be. Have to turn this direct memory input. Maximum GPU clock, it will improve the performance of the game. Enable the fast GPU readback, it will increase the performance of the game. So these are the basic settings that requires to run the game in a better FPS. This is how the performance of Pokémon Violet looks like, and it's running at 20 to 40 FPS. There are still freezing issues with Pokémon Violet. So that's it in this video. Don't forget to like, share and comment if you have any questions. Bye for now.